Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install MinGW compiler on a Windows operating system. And then I am also going to show you a simple hello world program on C language. So keep watching the video till the end so that you will be able to learn about how to install MinGW and also, you know, you can start programming in C language or C++ language as well. Okay, so please do subscribe our channel and please do like our video and also do share with your friends. So let's dive in into our video. So to download MinGW compiler, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser. You need to add this bar, you need to just simply search with MinGW compiler and you need to just simply hit enter and you'll get this, you know, MinGW minimalistic GNU for Windows download. So you need to just simply click on that and it will going to redirect to this sourceforge.net. I'm going to put this link in the description so that you can directly, you know, navigate to this site. You can see it has so many downloaded this week, so it is totally trustworthy. You need to just simply click on this download button and it's going to start downloading within 5 seconds. Okay, sometimes it might take some time, like it, you can see, like it again redirected, so it will download. Yeah, you can see it is downloaded now. So you need to click on the setup of MinGW. Let's minimize our download directory. Okay, so this is the installation wizard. You need to just simply click on install. So this is where our MinGW is going to be installed. So on our C drive, they're going to create MinGW. Everything is fine. You need to just simply click on continue. And you can see our download is progress. So the thing is, you need to have an active internet connection in order to, you know, to download all the files. So it is currently downloading. It will take some time. So once it everything gets downloaded, I'll come back to this video. So you can see all files and folders are downloaded. So we can just simply click on continue now. And once you click on continue, it's going to show this window. So here you can see that we have all these packages. So you need to just simply select each of them and click on mark for installation. So just keep on doing that. Keep on, you know, select and mark for installation. And once you're done with all of this, go to installation and click on apply changes. So just, you know, simply click on apply and it's going to again start, you know, downloading and, you know, installing all these packages. So again, you need to have active internet connection. So this process will take some time, and about 5 minutes I would say. So let's wait to, you know, to complete this process. So once it's done, I'll be again coming back. Yep, so you can see that our download is completed and it is currently extracting. So this extracting will take some time. So you can see that our extraction is, you know, completed successfully. So you can just simply close this dialog and you can close this or you can minimize this, anything you can do. So now that you know our MinGW is rightly installed, it's time to set up our environment variable. So for that, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in our C drive, you need to go to this MinGW folder which you have created. Just simply go inside that folder and then you'll see this bin folder. So go inside bin folder and now you need to click on this address bar, then right click and copy. That's it basically. Now you can simply minimize this and or click on this search icon, and here you need to just simply search with, you know, environ, and you need to click on this, you know, edit the system environment variable. This will open the system properties window. Here you need to click on environment variables. So you'll get this, you know, environment variables window over here. So you need to click on path and then you need to click on edit. So this will open this edit environment variable window. Here you need to click on new and right click and paste that path. So remember that path we have, you know, copied. So mingw/bin. So that path you need to paste over here. This is a very important step, guys. You need to do this, you know, so that our MinGW, you know, environment path gets set properly. Okay, this you need to do manually. So click on OK now. Again, click on OK. Again, click on OK. And now if you go to, you know, the search icon and just type over here CMD, it will open command prompt. And here if you just simply type G++\version and just simply hit enter, you can see that G++, that is MinGW GCC version 6.3.01 is rightly installed. Okay, so in this way you can easily install MinGW on your Windows operating system. Now I'm going to close this and going to show you a simple, you know, hello world program on C language and how to run that. So let's create a new folder and just simply name it as C practice. Okay, and I'll just simply go inside that folder and I'll just simply going to create a new text document and I'm going to name it as hello world, and I'm going to change this .txt with .c. okay, and I'm going to click outside and yes. So you need to change this extension first. Okay, you can use any text editor as well, like Visual Studio or you know Notepad++. I have made a detailed video on that on this channel. You can just you know simply find that link in the description. Not a problem. You need to change this extension. Just simply right click and open with the Notepad. Okay, and here I'm going to write a simple hello world program. So hash include you know stdio.h, sorry, it will be .h, and int main. I am going to you know open our parenthesis and I'm going to print, so printf hello world. Okay, similarly if you wish you can you know code in C++ as well. So you need to use that C++ syntax. You'll get the video as well on our channel if you you know want. So here I have written a simple you know C program. So hash include stdio int main printf hello world return 0. Why return 0? Because we have declared int, so we need to return something, so we are returning 0. If it's void then you don't need to return anything. Since it's int, you need to return 0. Go to file, save this program. Now you need to click on this address bar and type command prompt. So what it will do is it will open our command prompt right at this directory. See, on our you know desktop it has, we have created this C practice, so it is rightly opened over here. Now to run, you need to just simply type gcc and then your file name, which is hello world.c. so hello world.c, and just simply hit enter, and you can see that our program is rightly compiled. So it has created this a.exe. a.exe is basically the generated file, the output file you can say. So if you just simply you know type a and hit enter, you can see the output. So whatever you have written here, you know, the program, the output of that file will be you know stored on that generated exe. So here it is a.exe. To run, you need to type that a and it will going to you know show you the output. Okay, and we use gcc and then the file name dot your extension, that is c, in order to compile any C program. Okay, so that's you know pretty much all about this video. So I have shown you how to install MinGW, and then I have also shown you a simple hello world program on C. So now you can easily start you know practicing your C programs. Okay, so please do share with your friends, that will really help me to make more such videos. Okay, so please do share and don't forget to subscribe our channel, and please press the bell button so that every time I post any new video you get notified. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.